feels like. Rebecca's constantly with me, but I pretend she's not. It's like the Truman Show.
That's quality.
It's not even real life. I'm not even really getting my hair cut, I don't even have hair. It's just for the camera. This is the longest I've been without getting my hair cut.
Here at Rip Gym, we're lucky to have Fellas Barber. With Wes over there. He makes me look like super handsome all the time. So this is for the ladies, this episode, really. So you're welcome.
You're welcome.
You're welcome. So they got everything here at Rich. We've got Wes up here. We've got Sam next door. He's my chiropractor. He's a body alignment clinic, so he helps that. So yeah, everything's nicely consolidated into one area, so I don't have to keep going everywhere. Yeah, please don't leave. Can you just stay here, yeah? You gotta stay here. You stay here.
For later,
stay
here. You can call me
Barbara.
We're low at the closest level.
Yep.
You think that higher up?
Yep. I'm all yours for about 40 minutes.
40 minutes? You're getting all in on this one. And without the gutting.
I wouldn't watch it. I'd have to step away.
I'd definitely still watch it.
Yeah, I know.
You could hire me as Batman.
You will.
I could be Batman.
You could be Batman. You're more of a Bane.
Bane man.
Bane man. I'll just put you with like loads of venom coming out of your and all sorts, and then just added a Batman costume on top. Because of your aggressive size.
I would like to play a villain.
Ares.
Well, Ares is the villain for Wonder Woman, apparently. Yeah. Which would be cool. I think the Batman, what they should do is make it like 10 years before Batman Superman.
A Batman Origins.
No, not even Origins. He's been Batman a few years. There's no other superheroes, and all the main villains of Gotham that are now not in the DCU are still at large. And the villain should definitely be Black Mask.
Yeah, of course, Black Manta as well. He was the only obvious villain for Batman.
Yeah.
On Sunday, I'm going out for lunch. Well, I've got a photo shoot with Iron Rebel.
Yeah.
On Sunday morning, I'm doing that with Phil and Adia.
Right.
So I'm going out for lunch with, he's another pro, I'm going out for lunch with him, John Meadows, the owner of, and the owner of Iron Rebel, and Martin from Iron Rebel with you. We're all going out to Cheesecake Factory, I think. I need to try at least some good restaurants when I'm out there.
Cheesecake Factory. Winner.
I want to go to IHOP as well. She doesn't, she's on the phone.
Telephone voice.
She's like, hello? Yeah? Shut the fuck up! Yeah, so, yeah, that's what my mum's like.
That's just her sharing with the kittens.
Yeah, she's actually got kittens. I know, it's the older I've got, the more my mum swears, which is funny. Yeah, she's like, stop fucking swearing. Good contract, guest posing, winning a show, prize money. Like if I came top six at the Arnold, I've already done it.
Don't just use any baker powder. It's Johnson's bedtime baker powder. It smells nice.
You're trying to make me in a fucking sleep, that's what it is. Pixie dust.
Have a good one. What's up?
Still there, man. Bluntest knife ever. Always got a butterfly chicken. I'm probably doing a really shit job at this. So if you're watching, Gordon Ramsay, appreciate some advice. Mini fillet. Reason I just like the butterfly, then I think it cooks a little bit quick on the barbecue. Because we use the grill outside. And then, so I'm gonna grill up some chicken now, and then I'm gonna, and some steak,
I've got my rice cooker here, which has got my rice and it's got a steamer part on the top. So for my pre-workout meal is flank steak, rice and a bit of veg. All my other meals at the moment are just, so for my first meal I have, if you follow me, you've probably seen me post it on Instagram, is my egg whites and oats, which is pretty simple to make. Just weigh out my oats, add egg whites to the oats, and microwave it. So I microwave it a couple minutes, give it a stir, microwave it for a couple of minutes, give it a stir till it's ready, and it just creates like a porridge. And then I add some calorie-free syrup to it. So there's about 2.5 kilos of chicken in there. So we'll typically do around 3 to 4 days worth of meat in one go. So obviously Carly's still in her off-season, so she's eating a little more red meat than I am. So I have one steak meal a day, which is my pre-training meal. And then after training, more egg whites, and I have cream of rice from Go Nutrition. So this is just basically powdered rice. So what I'll do is mix up some water in the Tupperware, microwave it, and then I will cook egg whites in the pan on the stove separately, and I'll just mix them all together, and again, calorie-free syrup. So my first meal is the egg whites and oats, pretty simple. Second meal was normally, which I'll be eating in a minute after this, is just chicken. And I get 15 grams of carbs from peas, and I have 7 grams of added fat from the good oil. This is good, macadamia nut oil. So I have 7 grams of added fats. And then after that, a couple of hours later, will be my pre-training meal, which will be rice, a little bit of veg and steak, which I don't add fats to, because obviously you've got the fats in the steak. And then I'll train. After training is again the egg whites with the cream of rice, which I just talked about. That's it for carbs, we're done. So what, I've got 2 more meals left after that. And then meal 5, again, is chicken, macadamia nut oil, peas. And then before I go to bed, I have egg whites with a little bit of almond butter. And that's my meals for the day. So it's pretty low calorie, pretty low carb. My main source of energy at the moment is just those I'll get about 25, 30 grams of fats a day, and that's, I'm sort of running off that. Middle of the week, the diet's exactly the same on my hamstring day, but we normally add about 35 to 50 grams of carbs to each meal, apart from my last meal. But other than that, it all stays the same. And I also get intra-workout carbohydrates on my medium days. High day, which is tomorrow, which is legs. I probably remember I'm 2 weeks out tomorrow. So will be my last proper leg day, and my last high carb day. Probably getting about close to 1,000 grams of carbs tomorrow. And then that'll be to fill me out, to sort of tie me over for the next couple of weeks. So anyone who wants to know about the flank steak, this is your secret on the barbecue. Onion salt. It's a secret formula. Also the chicken, I'm quite liking this at the moment. This is just Asda's own spaghetti bolognese seasoning, and it's really good actually. So we changed the seasonings around. For steak it's always the onion salt. And this is the chicken. Rice is cooking for later. I'm gonna put some peas on now. So I have 200 grams of peas. Didn't even need to adjust it. 200, first attempt. Yes, I am touching raw meat, and yes, I am going to go and wash my hands. Chicken here, I normally leave the steak about five to 10 minutes aside, flip it. Chicken, it's normally about 3 to 4 minutes each side, I give it, and I just keep rotating, but the steak, I normally just flip the once. That's perfect. I fucked the chicken up, but the steak's perfect.
time to eat. I am starving. I'd normally use my fingers, but it'll burn my fingertips off. Still a bit hot. £240, done. Right, get my peas. I've already added the oil to the peas. Don't have to give a little swell. Delicious, low carb, shit fucking meal. That's gonna give me absolutely no energy whatsoever. I can't wait to eat it, to be honest. This is the secret. Colonel Seasons popcorn seasoning. There is absolutely no there's sodium, there's quite a lot of sodium. No carbs, no sugars, no protein, no fats, no calories. It's just a shitload of sodium, which I'm not bothered about sodium at this point. Not that I ever really am. Bon appetit. Okay, so what are we, 2 weeks out tomorrow?
Yep.
Yeah, 2 weeks out tomorrow. So this time next week, and not next week, the week after, I will be a day out from the show. So the plans are, I sent pictures to Justin this morning. We were actually just looking at them a second ago. And I've lost 4.5 pounds in 2 days. So I just put a comparison picture next to each other, and I've just, it's quite a significant difference in terms of flatness. So tomorrow's legs with Ben. And I'll be having my high day. It's pretty much the end of the day of the week that I'm a jolly fat bastard.
And sleepy.
And then, yeah, so tomorrow I have high day and quads, and it'll be my last heavy, big leg day. And my last sort of chance to really fill out. I'll take more pictures again Monday, then Wednesday, then Friday, and we'll just sort of adjust as we go. Because I know Justin won't want me getting too flat after next week. Obviously the flatter you get, the more you have to fill out, and I think the more you play around with those flatness versus fullness, you have to obviously put more carbs in, so there's more room for error. So I think Justin wants to coast into that last week, so I don't think I'll be getting too flat from here on out. We'll see what he does.
With the progress pictures, you normally see it in your legs though, don't you, when you're flat?
Yeah, legs. I mean, it's going to be your legs. I mean, I'm doing hour and a half cardio, I'm doing 3 half-an-hour sessions of cardio a day. Train legs twice a week, so yeah, they're going to go flat, which is a pain in the arse, because in the past, looking at my pictures, going to shows, I've always thought my legs, and especially the off-season, my legs are always a strong body part, and I've never brought my legs to the stage. They've always flattened off a little bit too much, so we're really trying to, this time, make sure that doesn't happen. So, but tomorrow's my favourite day of the week. Oh, I was saying earlier, with my high-carb day, I normally get up at 3 in the morning to have my first meal, because Ben and I train legs quite early, and I like to make sure I get at least 3 meals in and get an early night. So I'll pull my day back by about 5 hours, so I'll actually start eating at 3 in the morning and I'll be in bed by 9. Both being pro is quite nice. I mean, you turned pro a good year before I did. Mm. I have my
just shift. Remember that?
Well, now we've got to see against Olympia first.
The race is on. You will.
Yeah. And then I'll squash her. It was probably first, yeah, but I did the Olympia, so. So yeah, being pro, it definitely helps. It has its pros and cons. I'd say when we're prepping together, it's a lot easier, because we don't want to talk to each other. But I mean, I'm miserable as shit. She's dressed like a bag of sweets. She looks like a children's TV presenter. She walks in like, oh, I've had a great day. And I'll just fuck off.
No, I don't. I try not to talk to you.
You're like walking like, hi. I'm tired. But when we're both in prep, she normally dyes her hair darker. You start dressing like a bit of a goth, wear all black, and we're both just quiet. That's lovely, a bit of peace and quiet. So you start, yeah, it's
quite... I do give you a lot of time out though, don't I?
Not enough.
Oh, come on.
Not enough.
I do.
Not enough. The Carly actually starts. You start your prep work the day we get back from now, and that's when you go. And you're doing.
Yeah. At the moment, I'm doing like a pre-prep, aren't I? Getting rid of some of the unwanted fat, so I'm in a good place when I start prep.
Yeah, trimming the butter.
Yeah.
What show you do?
I'm doing Vancouver, so that's beginning of July. I wanted to do an earlier show, but I won't be ready. I wanted to improve a little bit more for the stage. So, yeah, I think you might be doing that one too.
Yeah, well,
see how it goes anyway.
Yeah, I'm here by flight out to Vancouver anyway, so I've got paid for the flight. So I might as well do the show.
If you're not qualified.
I'll probably still do it anyway.
Yeah.
Because recently Kevin Mavroney announced that he'll be doing the Vancouver Pro anyway, so I'm going to be there anyway to either watch. So I thought, you know, I might as well do it. So my plans for after the Arnold Classic is I'm going to do the Arnold, try and make a stamp, and then look at doing Toronto, which I think is about 10 weeks after the Arnold, which would be nice because it should give me a nice couple weeks to rest a little bit and then jump straight back into a prep for Toronto. And then I think it's 4 weeks after Toronto to Vancouver, so we're going to do two trips to Canada.
Canada's lovely, isn't it?
Yeah, and then, I mean, one of the main reasons I want to do Toronto is because Kylie did that show last year. And because you did it last year, I can visualise everything. And obviously, Nathan Diascher, a fellow UK pro, that was his first pro win, so it holds a little bit of prestige for me. And I've been there, I can visualise the stage, I know where we'll be staying, I know where the gym is, I know where the shops are, so mentally it's easy to prepare for.
I think, as you said about being a pro couple, I think it's in a way easier that you're both pro, because as soon as you turn pro, your mindset changes and you are doing everything to another level, aren't you? You know, I think you become a lot more professional with it. When you diet, it's just, you just get on with it. Because every other pro is doing exactly the same. Every pro is training their ass off, they're eating their meals. So I think it just, you have that at the back of your mind. If you're not training hard, there's always gonna be one of the other pros training harder that you're gonna be on stage with.
You're not there, are you? Well,
you stay there. Yeah, you stay there.
Definitely being a pro, I thought I worked hard for the British, which obviously I did, but this is like, no, it's almost another, it is another level, and I had to even try and peel back more from myself, which I didn't quite know was there. And I think every time we compete, and you know you've got to dig deeper in yourself a little bit. And this, for me, I'm doing the Arnold as well. That's my pro debut. I mean, what an idiot I am. I'm doing the fucking Arnold Classic as my first show, and it's going to be baptism by fire. So I need to really dig deep. Which is like, it's funny because I see, I mean, I've been chatting with a few of the other pros doing the show, and they're like, do you still get cheat meals? I'm like, I start sushi once a week. And they're like, ah, don't get anything. And I'm like, fuck, maybe I'm doing it wrong. So I keep like, I'm like, Justin, should we be doing high days? But it's working, so, you know, I'm putting 1,000,000% into every, so 6 days of the week I feel like shit. And it's a drag, and you know, you can see by my diet, I'm eating fucking chicken and peas. I mean, what is that?
Yeah, but then you get the high day.
Exactly.
So
I mean, you see a lot of other coaches. I mean, like Chris Aceto give you like the muffins and stuff. So I'm basically aggressively pulling as much fat off as I can through the week, filling back up, and then hammering it again for the week. So it's almost like I'm resetting my body once a week. In the past, I think I've gone too flat for too long, with metabolism stalled and things like more cardio, less food has to be put in. But I think the high days just doesn't need to be done as much. And I keep seeing. I mean, now I think I'm about 10 pounds. My body, okay, well, my condition now is almost what it was on stage at the British, give or take a couple of pounds. I mean, so I think if I dried out right now, I could be ready, I could match my condition from the British in 2 days. But I'm about 10 pounds heavier. And I think this time it's working with Justin, we've worked out a lot more kinks, and he's been less afraid to fill me up, but not quite as afraid to get me flatter. So when I do fill out, I'm filling out a lot. I'm literally filling out more, not spilling so much.
Because this close to the show, you don't really sleep a lot anyway, do you?
Oh, last night,
no one does.
Last night was shit. I just found a bit of cheer snoring all night. And then I just couldn't sleep. I think I was up for about 4 hours straight, just like,
Do you like think when you're actually awake? Because with me, when I'm prepping and close to a show, all I'm thinking about is falling off stage or going through my routine, because you're so busy in the daytime doing everything that the only time you actually ever think is like when you're trying to sleep?
No, I think...
You don't think of anything?
No, I look at my watch. Food? I look at my clock, yeah. I look at my phone and think, I've got 4 hours and 18 minutes before I get to eat again. Yeah. But first, I need to do cardio before that. No, actually, my hunger pangs haven't been too bad in the night. But I said in the last video, part of the issues you have with a competition prep is you're just never comfortable. Mm. So I'm lying in bed, exhausted. I'm lying down. You've got a nice mammoth mattress bed where I'm sleeping. I'm on a lovely bed. Last night we had brand new, fresh, clean bed sheets on. And all day I was thinking, I can't wait to get into bed because I'm fucking tired. And my body did not let me sleep.
Well, we'll check in first. And then we'll look around to find some shops to go and get food.
Completely wrong. You've made that completely wrong. I'm getting all my food delivered.
Yeah. So
I'm going to sleep.
Okay. Well, I need to get my food because obviously I'm still prepping. So, and then scout around where the gym is, even though it's about 10 minutes away, you said.
Yeah, there's my powerhouse gym there. I'm very lucky because I've been in contact with IFBB Pro. Ken Jackson, who runs Fit Foods RX over in the States, and I'm going to be getting all my meals prepped by his company. Mm. They're going to deliver them to the hotel, get a fridge in the room, so I'll just get whatever Justin decides I'll be eating those last few days. It'll be quite tentative because things might change. You know, I can just get chicken rice, steak and rice, and then I can add carbs to it, or take carbs away, add fats to it if I need to. So that'll take a lot of stress off. But I think what we're going to do is, you know those massive baby carriers? We're gonna get a giant, we're gonna basically buy a hammock, and I'm just gonna sleep on Carly. She's gonna carry me to the airport.
I'm not that strong.
So we land then, and then that night I'll probably just get the rest of my meals in, get comfortable in the hotel, unpack.
Posing,
meet some people.
We're gonna tan as well, aren't we?
I think my first coat of tan is on the Wednesday night, actually, with Pro Tan. And then Thursday, again, I'll go to the gym, get some blood moving around. I'll probably be holding water from the flight. I don't know, I've never flown this close to a show ever, so I don't know how much. It might dry me out.
Yeah.
So we don't know. And then you've got the athletes meet and greet, which is going to be crazy. Because I'm actually more of a fan than I am a competitor at the show, so I get to meet all the other pros in the meet the pros. Which is actually just in the hotel, so I'd have to go anywhere for that. And then Friday, the expo, I'm going to be on Flex Lewis's booth at the expo for a few hours on Friday. And then the rest of the day on Friday, I'm going to relax, keep checking with Justin. Because Justin will be out there on Wednesday with me. And then Saturday is game day. So I wake up, Justin will come to my room, check I'm all right.
That's a lot easier because he's never been to any show before.
No.
So at least, you know, you've got that.
Yeah, so I've actually got a couple sets of eyes to look at me. I mean, they say too many cooks spoil the kitchen, but I've basically got the master chefs to look at me. I've got Justin, Matt Jansen's going to be there, and he's offered to have a look at me, and obviously Jordan Peters, who's a close friend of ours, he's going to be there, and so they can all...
That'll keep you calm anyway.
...give their opinion, you know, and I'm sure they'll all have bounce ideas of each other. This thing is you realise that when your idols become your rivals, you realise we're all the same, we're all just the same.
Yeah. Before you've never met them or spoke to them, you think they're like these superhuman kind of people that you're never going to meet, and then when you're actually there with them, it's a bit of a shock first of all, I think. But when I was backstage at Toronto, I was just staring.
Yeah, being backstage, I'm gonna be like, what am I doing?
Yeah.
What am I doing? That's what I'm gonna be backstage. No, but I think it's just gonna be a good. It's gonna be a good experience. I mean, I'm on track to be my best ever. So if I bring my best and I can hang with the best, then I'll be more than happy. That'll be a success for me. And then as soon as Saturday is over, it's full steam ahead to the next one, and then just keep moving forward.
Mm.
But yeah, this is I am the underdog, as they say. Oh, if you like these Iron Rubber videos, we've been getting a lot of good feedback. I mean,
so many people have been sharing them.
Yeah, so thank you to everyone who's been watching and posting and buying the clothing, supporting the brand and supporting me. Why'd you have to ruin that take? Fuck your mum. Your mum doesn't wear Iron Rebel. If she wore Iron Rebel, I might as well say, I'm not even going to say her name. hello, Jackie. I'm spending a few hours on my laptop, so I don't know if anyone wants to see that. If you want to see a video of me just on my laptop, we can arrange that.
Or doing the selfie. Hard at work.
Yeah, hard at work. Yeah, hard at work in my Starbucks. So, as I said, thank you everyone for watching, for sharing, subscribing. I didn't expect them to be as popular, so we've still got a few more to come after this.
Not many more,
because we got two. Really
there.
We've got one more after this, and we'll probably do maybe a wrap-up video, a bit afterwards. So the wrap-up video will be good, because it'll be probably like a week afterwards, and I'll have this big bloated face.
And you'll have a personality, you'll be happy.
Yeah, you know, like, have you seen Dodgeball at the end when Ben Stiller's like on the sofa, like just covered in like pizza boxes.
Mega rebound.
That'll be the recap. Like, how did you get on?
Yeah, was he ever in shape?
It was good. Just covered in crumbs and mustard sauce.